Electric atmosphere again tonight here inside SAP Center in San Jose. Avalanche four-game winning streak ended on Friday, but today is a chance for them to earn the split and send it back to Denver with game three coming up on Tuesday night. Bertl, a little stutter step there on Barry, gets in front, and his shot deflected away from the net. Rodil feeds it to the back, shot by Carlson, save made by Grubauer.
And he takes that shot right off the pass, and that's a good save by Grubauer. As you can see, all those players in front of him, he gets in a position and goes off the left pad and in.
And eventually it comes to Kevin LeBanc. Thornton across for Sorensen. Sorensen opens it up, a shot from Braun, stick to the glass by Grubauer. JT Comfort looking to create as he peels off along the boards. Nothing there, not yet. Found Nieto as he popped into the high slot. And that one stuck to the pads of Jones. The struggle in the opening minutes. And so far, so good for Martin Jones and helped out by Michael Haley. Rodil again spinning. He'll leave it off onto the forehand of Hurdle. Out for Burns. A wrist shot, tip save, rebound, they score! Evander Kane on the rebound.
Colorado knew that the size and ability of San Jose down low might be an issue.
Yeah, there's just too many big guys. Kane 6'2", 210. Hurdle 6'2", 215. Thornton 6'4", 220. Meyer 6'2", 210. There are too many big guys right now, and Colorado's not figuring it out.
And the other thing that's happening is that when Colorado does have a chance to shoot it,
here's an opening for Comfort, and the biggest save of the game so far for Martin Jones. LeBanc sent it ahead. Nice keep by Comfort. Comfort feeds it. Calvert shoots it. Save made by Jones. The follow-up try deflected out of play by Brent Burns.
San Jose can't get the puck out. Good job by Colorado to keep it in. Calvert with the wrist shot forces Jones to make a good save.
On the only goal of the game is Mikko Rantanen here. Sends it over for Landeskog. To the net goes McKinnon. Saved by the left leg of Jones. A remarkable stop here in the final minute of the period. The other way, Couture for LeBanc, and a glove save by Grubauer.
Wow. Oh, did he stare him down, Joe? Going into the second period, just stares him down and rips it out of the air. Well done by Philip Grubauer.
Now down the other end, only six saves in this period for Jones, but how about this one? That deflection, he stretches out with the left leg about as far as he could on Nathan McKinnon, who just pulls his way to the front of the net.
Soderberg up with it. Across the ice, Girard. Samuel Girard changes directions, changes places with Makar. The puck left behind. Makar spins free of Kane. Takes a shot right into the belly pad of Martin Jones.
He and Girard do a little cross and drop. That's Evander Kane. He's a responsible defensive player. Makar makes him look bad.
Stalled in the corner, pumps free from Michael Haley. Slow rolling puck mishandled there by Burns, and a foot race. Gabriel Bourque tied up, followed up by Broussard, and he shot it high.
That was a rolling puck, but he comes back to help out defensively, and that gave Derek Broussard an excellent chance. Broussard just follows up and has that chance, a real good opportunity to tie this game.
All three of those guys are over 6'2", and they're all over 215 pounds.
Logan Couture steps and shoots, save made, rebound there, and covered up by Grubauer.
Thought about shooting, tried to regain control of that, and by that time he was defended.
Erik Karlsson trying to take what they give him. He got through, but he got knocked down. Now he has the puck at the side of the net and jams it on goal.
That's more like the Erik Karlsson fans are expecting to see here in San Jose.
Big guns out there for the Avalanche. Landeskog on the spin move. Has it again. Landeskog to the slot. Barry to the net. A shot off the outside of the goal from Rantanen, who drops to the ice in disbelief. Barry. His spin move gets away from Rodil. Wrist shot. Score! Tyson Barry sneaks one through. We're tied.
And eventually one shot. Rantanen actually gets hit with a high stick. And then Tyson Barry looks and gets the shot through and gets a deflection on the way in.
Evander Kane cruising in while his line mates make a change. Kane sat down by Zadorov. Nikita Zadorov ready for that cutback. Dillon across. Carlson's drive pinballed off of Grubauer.
And he's going to come up large with the right pad. And Nikita Zadorov, we talked about the importance of him being on the ice for that reason right there.
30 goals in the regular season for Meyer. Had his second of the playoffs in game one of this series. Is Rantanen in front. Landeskog won't go. Barry, he scores! Tyson Barry. And the Avalanche have their first lead of the game.
Rantanen gets it out front, and then Tyson Barry on the rolling puck puts it up and over the blocker.
Here comes the Colorado power play. 33 seconds to operate with. McKinnon jumps free. Barry and McKinnon go back and forth to the front, and Jones makes a save. And the key, no rebound, with Landeskog ready and waiting. Two pretty slick skating defensemen on the ice for the Avalanche, and Girard and McCarr. And it's Girard going coast to coast. Girard still with it. Takes a look, forced it into the crease. Save made by Jones. Broussard was deposited into the Sharks' net, and that's the reason for the whistle. Barry for Rantanen. Rantanen to the front. The redirection that time from Landeskog wouldn't go, but it's a loose in front of the net. Battled for. Pops free. Barry, backhand blocker save. Pops behind for Broussard in front. A save by Jones. Point blank on board. Kane the other way. Ian Cole with a quick change of directions. Nyquist to the front and a stop by Grubauer. Logan Couture with a great look. The San Jose bench, and that's a good sign for the Sharks. Sorensen. Played across, and Barry turning alone in front. Calvert went to the backhand, and Jones, they score! It got through Jones, finished off by Nieto. And the Avalanche lead 3-1.
Watch the skill level of Calvert, not there, but coming up there. He pushes that puck, and I do think Nieto will get credit because Brendan Dillon's there. But it's this little slick play by Calvert right there. He pulls it into his body, and then Nieto's there. Johnny on the spot.
Approaching 8 minutes left is Thornton. Sends it for Sorensen. He's got LeBanc. Sorensen cuts back. Saved by Grubauer on the rebound. Karam's off to the corner. LeBanc up with it. Carlson straight away. Glove down and held on to by Grubauer. Comes out for Carlson. All the way over for Burns. That shot blocked by Kerfoot, who lost his skate blade. As Burns scores!
Watch Kerfoot. He's going to get in the lane on Burns. The blade's going to pop right out of his skate. Puck's going to go to Carlson, who'll keep it in. He'll distribute to Burns, who should be being watched by Kerfoot. He can't because he's got a broken blade. And Burns is smart enough to get that puck deflected as well.
Puck bunched up below the goal line. Pops to the front. Fended off by Grubauer. Calvert, he got leveled, but he made the play. And McKinnon will put it in.
I just think that he didn't want to take the icing and was so calm with the puck and looked for any safe place to put it. And it just happened to be on the side with McKinnon and his speed.
Off the faceoff, Avalanche win the draw. Couture keeps it in. 13 seconds left. Sharks need two. They get one. Burns, his second of the game. 10 seconds to go.
And it's a one-goal game with 10 seconds remaining.
They get it on goal. Blockered away by Grubauer. 6 seconds remaining. Hurdle behind the net with four. Comes back out. Carlson with two. One last try is blocked. And the Colorado Avalanche hang on and even the series, headed back to Denver. The game winner winds up being Nathan McKinnon's empty net goal at 18:58 of the third period. And Philip Grubauer held the Sharks off when they were trying to tie the game late.